And this is the final answer, root 2. times 3. This is the factorization of 27. So now I have under the square root, I have 3 numbers. I can take only one of them outside the root. So I'm going to take only 1, 3. And this is the remainder. It has to stay under the root. Like this. So I'm going to take one of these outside the root, and this is the remainder of the operation. Another example. 5 root 54. Now we are going to factorize 54. So I'm going to take only one of these three outside the square. So I'm going to end up with 5, and this is the 3 which I took from the square root. I'm going to end up with 2 multiplied 3 under the square root. So the final answer is 5 multiplied 3 equals 15 root 6. Another example. In this example, we can move this 3 which is outside the root to inside the root. Or we can multiply both of them by root 3 up and down. Why? To remove this root. It is not accepted to have the root in the denominator. That's why we are trying to remove it. Now I'm going to end up with root 6. Another exercise, simplify. I have root 45 minus 2 root 20 and plus 2 root 5. Another exercise. Let's start with this one. I'm going to factorize 45 as we did in the previous exercise, and I'm going to end up with 3 root 5. I can use the calculator. In the square root, you can use the calculator. But actually, we are teaching you how to factorize, because in the cubic root, it might be some difficulty in finding the result by using the calculator. So, here we have 2. And root 20 after factorization is going to be 2 root 5. So I'm going to add all these terms. Why? Because all of them are like terms. Root 5, root 5, and root 5. As if we have x, x, and x. So I'm going to end up with root 5. Now the last one. This is the 2. And this is the factorization of root 18, which is 3 root 2. And root 50 is, the factorization of root 50 is 5 root 2. And the factorization of 42, there is no factorization for it. I'm going to remove the square root 2 from the denominator by multiplying it up and down with root 2. Now, this is the end of the addition process. I think there is a mistake here, but you can solve it by using this sign and ignore this one. Now, another exercise, and I think we are going to start. Do it by yourself and check by seeing the answer. As we did, we are going to distribute this number on the bracket. So I'm going to multiply these two numbers plus multiply these two numbers. Now, for this one, I'm going to check for the distribution. So now, I'm going to start with this, multiply by this number, and again, multiply by this number, and negative 5 multiplied by 3 root 2, negative 5 multiplied by 5. So, the final answer is negative 7. Now, I have a bracket, and all raised to power 2. This means that I have a bracket of root 2 plus root 6 multiplied by another bracket, and it has the same numbers, because power 2 means that you are multiplying the number by itself. So I'm going to solve it like this. I'm going to remind you how to solve this. The first number is squared, so root 2 power 2 gives me 2. The second number is squared, so root 6 power 2 gives me 6. And the middle number is the multiplication of root 2 multiply root 6 multiply 2. And if you don't know this, how to work with this exercise, you can just write down root 2 plus root 6, multiply root 2 plus root 6, and do the distribution process as we did here. After that, I'm going to add the like terms together. This is the end of our lesson. I think it's a very easy one. I hope you like it, and try to solve some exercises, and send me the answers on the WhatsApp. Good luck. Thank you.